My Skype was not loading. I was
Are you
sitting
good?
here and it was just it said accept or block, and I'm like accept, it's not doing anything. So
Is it better if I use my like headphones or just talk without them?
I can hear you perfectly. How does it
Okay.
sound for you? Can you hear me?
Yeah, sounds good. Yeah.
Cool. This will be just like our little familiarization, and then we can roll straight into the podcast from there. Exciting.
Perfect.
Yeah, no,
Yeah.
don't worry about the intro. Like we can hash that out right now. So
Okay.
that's not an issue. So you're in North Carolina, huh?
Yeah, Wilmington.
Wilmington. That's not far. That's awesome.
Yeah, y'all are close. I looked it
Yeah,
up.
Jacksonville.
Wait, nuh-uh.
Yeah.
I'm gonna be there tomorrow.
Really?
Yeah.
What are you up to?
My brother-in-law lives up there.
Is he a Marine?
His wife
His wife's a Marine?
Yeah.
There we go. Look at that twist. That's awesome.
Yeah. So I'm going to
Very
be up
cool.
there this weekend.
Yeah. It's a good
So
place.
funny.
I love Wilmington, but Jacksonville's our home. So
Yeah. What, are you military?
I'm a Marine.
Nice.
Yeah, so it's very small world. That's awesome.
That is so
Very
funny. Yeah,
cool.
I feel like if you live up there, you have like automatically
Yeah,
there.
that's what I was like. I don't think I'm gonna miss if I ask.
Yep,
There's a
you're
good
nailing
chance. Cool.
it.
Oh, so you said you're a graphic designer.
Yeah.
Okay. Are you, is it like freelance or?
Yeah. Well, I
Okay.
work for a company here
Yeah.
doing, it's called N2 Publishing. I do like graphic design magazines for wealthier neighborhoods. But then I also freelance like 15 hours a week.
Wow. Yeah, that's definitely entrepreneurship right there. That's,
Yeah,
yeah.
because I love it and don't want to just work the 9 to 5 forever, you know?
Yeah, no way. That does not sound. I mean, some people love it, but people like us, we are looking for something different.
Yeah. No, I was like, well, I have to be careful what I say on this because I know people I work with will like probably listen to it, so I can't be like, I'm trying to get out. So,
Yeah, I know the feeling. What did you? I saw your podcast yesterday. I didn't know you were so disgruntled. It's like, what?
didn't know you were trying to leave.
Yeah. Yep. Do you want me to call you freelancer, or would you like your intro to sound like?
You can just say that.
No? Okay. Do you have? I know I was. Eileen was. She was showing me some stuff, but I want to make sure I have it straight from you. So, do you want to talk about the company you work at, or the on the
I'll just talk
side?
about my freelance stuff.
Okay.
I'll just leave them out completely.
Yeah. They're like no shout out. What would you like me to call it? Or do you just want to say freelance design?
It's Kyle Myers design, but you can just say freelance.
I'm on like two different screens. So my podcast has a habit of cutting out.
Oh no.
Yeah. Well, it happens. It doesn't happen every time. But if the video goes out, we'll just keep going. Because the audio is still there. And then usually it's like your face is frozen in a really awkward pose, and
That's
it's pretty funny, and then I
me.
get yelled at after. But it's good. Like, no issues. This is not formal. This is really informal. It's supposed to just
Yeah,
be a
no. I love it.
conversation. Oh, my screen's gone. Can you hear me though? See, look at that. Interesting. Skype changed everything. Okay, welcome back to Skype.
Oh, I saw you for a second, and then you went away.
See? Yeah, I'm trying to. What? Skype is playing with my heart right now. Can you hear me? Can you hear me? Can you hear me? It's like literally as soon as I warned you, it cut off. I was telling the truth. Okay, I'm good. I think sound sounds good. You can hear me, I can hear you. Okay, video's good. Anything weird with the script? Anything you feel uncomfortable with in the script? Okay, right. I'm gonna go, as much with the conversation, and then I'll pull stuff from the script. But if the conversation goes away from the script, that's okay. It's not a big deal. Cool. We are good there. You call it Kylie Milligan Designs?
Kyle, just like the boy name.
I'll see you looking at. Like, I would be calling you Kylie the whole night.
Nope. I should have, I almost made a note because literally every single person does that.
I like it. No, that's cool.
But really forgot.
It's my fault. Okay. So Kyle Milligan.
Yep, M
Okay.
Myers. Sorry. Oh my gosh, I called you on the wrong account. I'm just the worst right now.
No, you're good.
Yep.
Kyle Myers Designs.
Yep.
Okay.
Yeah, I got married and haven't switched account.
Got it. Yeah, my wife still has Holtz, which is her last name, her maiden name, on a lot of stuff, especially Facebook and stuff, so
Yep.
I know the struggle.
It's just such a pain to change everything, you
Yeah,
know?
yeah.
I don't
Cool,
have time for
cool.
all that.
You good?
Yeah.
It's not a problem. Okay, we'll just roll into it. I already have a video taping. I'll press record and we'll just go.
Sounds good.
Cool. All right, we are on another episode of Pass the Torch podcast. Today, our guest is Kyle Myers. Okay, Kyle Myers is actually in North Carolina, a fellow North Carolinian. She is a freelance graphic designer, and she is running her own company Kyle Myers Designs. So, Kyle, awesome to have you on Pass the Torch podcast. Thank you so much. Welcome.
Thank you.
So we are going to get straight into it. Graphic design. What motivated you to start into graphic design? What's your why for graphic design?
Well, I wanted to be a marine biologist. That's where the Wilmington came in.
Yeah.
Once I kept not passing biology, my parents sat me down and they're like, you need to pick a different life choice because you're not going to make it.
Yeah.
So I've always loved art, and graphic design was like the last like frontier of like people that are, you know, making money as artists. So kind of went into that, and I love it. And I just really fell in love with like branding small businesses, especially those that are woman owned, just that like girl power,
yeah,
everything about that. So I just love, especially like here in Wilmington, there's a lot of like boutique startups and like bloggers and photographers. Weddings are really big down here, so just like getting to know like those ladies and bring like their ideas to like their brand and just see their company thrive. I just love that.
Definitely. So you went from biology to graphic design. Like, I don't know, that is not, you know, your normal, easy, seamless transition. Like, did you draw before that? Because I'm a stick figure guy. Like, how did you make that transition?
I don't think I was ever meant for the science route.
Yeah.
I just like the idea of like being in the ocean all the time. And
yeah.
I think that's where I really liked that idea, but the actual science part of it was completely lost on me.
That's really interesting.
Very much more art driven than science driven.
So did you draw in class? Like, how did that side of you get inspired?
I took like art all growing up, and like absolutely loved it. Would skip all my like high school classes, so, like just go hang out with art class and draw and paint.
Graffiti, graffiti on the city walls.
So just loved that. And then college kind of like the same deal. I was like, you know, if I'm gonna be here, I might as well take classes that I want to go to. Yeah. And I was like, how can I get a degree out of this?
Absolutely. Very cool. And so with that, you actually, from just having a passion for it, you're turning that into a company.
Yeah.
Very cool.
Yeah. Like, if I'm gonna be an adult and do the whole adult thing. I saw my parents work, you know, 9 to 5s in offices, and I was just like, that's not for me. So I was like, what can I do? Or if I can work from home, like pick my own schedule, work with people that I actually want to work with, and do something that I love to do.
Yeah. Were your parents really supportive of that? Like, you said that they were like, hey, this isn't probably your strength, you should look at this or something else. Like,
yeah.
How supportive are they now?
Right after college, I went up to D.C. and I was doing graphic design up there. Perfect. And I think once they saw that, like, people will pay money for me to do this, they were like, oh, okay, like, you're actually going to make it as an adult. And then when I decided to, you know, move down here and kind of do my own thing, they were cool with it and they support it.
Yeah.
I think I wasn't meant for the suits then. Sitting in the office all the time, much more like the yoga pants on the couch.
Definitely.
Kind of vibe.
I mean, you know, it's funny because, you know, people look at the biologist or the doctors or the lawyers, and you know what? I have nothing but respect for those professions, but doing other things, like, yes, we might be wearing different attire, but we work our butts off too, and we grind just as hard, and we're out there doing, you know,
my favorite quotes of all time is the entrepreneur is the only person that'll work 80 hours so that they don't have to work 40.
Exactly.
And I love that.
Yeah. No, that's incredibly true. Like, you can't really compare them because they're different fields, but yeah, people aren't, if they don't know about entrepreneurship, they don't really understand what kind of work ethic goes into it. And then for an entrepreneur like you have to work your own hours. You have to self-motivate. And at the end of the tunnel, there's no guarantee of what you're going to be able to do.
Right. I feel like it's way more fun, you know. I get to wear like so many different hats. I have to be the business person. I have to like go out there and market myself. Then I have to come back and like do the art side of it. There's just, you know, you get to do a lot where in a normal job, I feel like you have one
Yeah.
kind of goal and that's what you're working towards all the time. Where over here, I'm doing stuff that I didn't even know that I was gonna have to end up doing. Like figuring out the legal stuff of being an entrepreneur. That's stuff that never crossed my mind, but
Yeah.
I'm learning it.
Absolutely. There's so much you have to be willing to be open to learn and I mean, a lot of it's not going to be your strength straight up. You're going to be like, I have no idea what North Carolina law is for
Right.
such and such, and then you have to research it, and now you know.
That's why you have to surround yourself with people that know
Yeah.
how to like coach you.
Absolutely.
Bringing it full circle here.
Yeah. Mentorship. There we go. Definitely. So, speaking of Kyle Designs, Kyle Meyer Designs, tell us a little bit about like your most current project.
Actually, right now I'm branding a church,
Wow.
which isn't really like in my normal client base. But this church here in Wilmington reached
Yeah.
out to me, and you know, they had a little bit of an older demographic, and they're like, we like what you do, we wanna, you know, kinda update everything. And so I'm working with them right now, and it's so different, but I'm loving it.
Yeah.
And it's crazy because it's with like a whole board of like a whole panel of people, you know, it's not just like one business owner. And so there's a lot of different like opinions coming in, but it's been really good. And my other project right now is a honey farmer up in upstate New York.
Yeah.
And he's just like local, small town boy farmer.
Yeah.
And he's been awesome. He let me kind of do whatever I want. He was very much focused on it just needs to look good. I didn't really care.
It's great guidance. I like it.
Yeah,
Yeah.
so I just kind of, you know, did my own thing, and he ended up loving it. And it was a super easy client, and we're getting it printed on these adorable little honey bottles right
Yeah.
now, and it's just so fun.
Oh, that's too cool.
Yeah, so
Well,
such a wide range.
yeah. So how do these businesses find you have a church and a honey farmer? Like, how did they converge on Kyle Myers?
Well, in Wilmington, just you know, getting out there, getting to know people, and I feel like that helps like
Yeah.
travel, news travels fast, you know. Especially when you say that you want to work with like female-owned businesses, I feel like that's such a like tight niche that you know
Yeah.
people kind of like latch on to that. The honey farmer, I actually went to college with him,
Oh,
so
nice. Yeah.
yeah, so it's been funny to reconnect with him and see what he's doing.
Tell me a little bit about the women in business. Like, how are you going about networking and really making yourself someone who's known as someone who wants to empower the other women around them and connect and network?
We have it's like a there's a nationwide group called the Rising Tide Society,
Nice.
but it's for creatives, like entrepreneur creatives. But we have a chapter here in Wilmington, and we have monthly meetings, and I go to those, and it's mostly women. It's open to guys, but I feel like just the branding of it kind of like draws women to come to it, and it's in the middle of the day, so it's all these women who like work for themselves, are doing startups,
Yeah.
and so that's been really awesome. I feel like down here in Wilmington, the big business is weddings, so everyone is a
Yeah.
wedding photographer or a calligrapher or wedding planner. So just getting to like meet all of those ladies, I feel like everyone's gonna need a brand at some point.
Definitely.
Everyone is putting off a brand, even if they don't know they're putting off a brand, and
Wow.
so like. Once you tell people that they're already giving off a certain vibe and like pushing away clients or drawing clients in, they're like, oh, well, I need to figure out what that is. And if I like the people I'm drawing in, if I'm getting my ideal client by doing that, and especially, you know, connecting with women and just getting a drink, going out for a margarita, it's just so easy, you know?
Definitely, especially in Wilmington. Wilmington is
Yeah.
the perfect place to go out and have a good time. The weather,
Yeah.
that's where me and my wife go when we want to have a nice night out. So it's
Yeah,
different
that.
environment. So you said something about everyone has a brand. That's a really interesting point. So I just want you to kind of expand on that, and how do you bring that into Karl Meyer designs, and then how do you talk to other people about that? Because I'm sure some people are, oh, I agree with you 100%, and then other people are like, Kyle, what are you talking about? I don't understand. A brand is like Walmart, or a brand is Oprah. How am I as a normal person, how do I have a brand?
Yeah, so everyone is just, everyone has their, like, vibe, you know. I feel like the way, what you put out in the world is, like, that's the people that you're attracting back to yourself.
Yeah.
And I always tell clients when they're, like, I have no idea, like, what my brand is, I'm, like, well, ask your, the people who know you the best, ask your spouse, ask your friends, like, what would they say that your brand is, you know? Are
Yeah.
you, like, the 9 to 5, like, in a suit, nice outfit, like, working hard, killing it, or are you like the stay-at-home mom who like is chilling in her yoga pants, like doing it all? And that's just like totally different, like that's gonna attract a different person back to your business, you
Yeah.
know? And I always try to put out like small town beach girl, like always down for a margarita, never gonna like turn down a good time, always just wanna chill with people, nice and relaxed, like that's what I'm trying to put out there. I'm not going to be meeting you in a boardroom
No.
kind of deal. And so once you tell people that like they are putting out some type of vibe, like let's brand your business on this. Is this what you want? Because I just had a client actually that it was these two moms and they were just going into their business way too seriously. And that was great, but they were trying to attract, they were selling baby clothes.
Yeah.
And I felt like their brand was just so serious, and I was like, this is a fun company. Like, you can be silly. You're designing baby clothes. Like, this is supposed to be fun. Like, you're putting an elephant on a shirt. Like, don't try to come in here in a pencil skirt and heels and then hand me an elephant on a shirt. And so it's just like helping to hone in, like, to be the best brand you can to connect with people.
Yeah, no, that's very cool. So harnessing that, do you recommend like we do websites to build our brand? We like send out cards every once in a while. So you have a, because that's something I've been talking to my wife about, is, and it's really cool. We have very close friends, and they'll send Christmas cards and stuff like that. And I'm starting to realize that's kind of part of their family brand, and we're trying to
Yeah.
do the same thing ourselves. So.
Yeah, well, with businesses, I love Instagram.
Yeah.
I mean, it's free marketing, it's super visual. I mean, if I feel like if you're not using Instagram for your company, then you're just like totally missing the mark because it's free, it's right there. Everyone's on Instagram.
Absolutely.
Like on average, people are checking Instagram twice an hour. And that's not like that's counting the hours that we're asleep. So we're checking it more than twice an hour during
Yeah.
our awake hours. And to just not be like putting your brand out there, I feel like you're just really missing the mark. And that's one thing I always try to like push at people. I'm like, especially if you run your business out of your personal account,
Yeah.
I feel like there's gonna come a time where you're gonna wanna post a picture that might not fit within your company brand. And I'm like, just don't do it. Don't do it, whatever you do, like just resist the like selfie with your dog because unless that's what you're going for, if you're selling dog toys and then your dog is your brand, like go for it. But otherwise, like hold off because it's free marketing. People are on it all the time and it seems not aggressive. You know, it's not go to my website. You don't have to be super like pushy, super trying to sell a product. Like everyone's on Instagram. It's supposed to connect. You can have your brand on there and it seems like just a friend like checking up on your life. And
Yeah.
I feel like that's just like the best way right now with where we are to push out your brand. And then that carries over to your website, to how you are in interviews, how you are on your business card, you know, just everything.
Cool. As a graphic designer, what do you think for adding like to your personal websites? Do you think that you should have like from the colors to the font, something that really identifies you, like your cover photo and your profile picture, or just take anything.
I totally do. I'm like such a stickler for that though. And some people will say, you know, that's not the most important,
Yeah.
but I want everything like down to the fonts to like identify with the person who I'm
Yeah.
branding. I just think that is gonna make you seem so much more legit. I mean, how many times have you gone to a website for something and their website is just a mess? And it's like, I can't take this business seriously because they can't even get their website together to look professional. Like, how are they going to be running a professional business? I feel like that's like our new first impression. And it's just, you should be trying to match that across all platforms so that you look most professional. It connects with you. Because truth is, like, everyone is like, so many people are doing the same thing that you are already doing. There's a million wedding photographers, there's a million graphic designers, there's a million people running a podcast. But like, people are gonna buy into your business because they connect with you, not because they connect with your business. Like,
Huge.
people want to identify like with you. Do they feel like you're someone that they can just like go out for a drink with and connect and feel like you're friends? Or is it just gonna feel like another business meeting? And I feel like that's where people are like signing over their loyalties, you know? Like, you're gonna pick someone that you want to be around to work with.
Very cool. If you were working with a client, because one thing I'm seeing a lot in design is extremely important. I'm not just saying that because I'm talking to you. It's incredible because one thing, it catches your eye immediately, and you make up your mind about what you're looking at probably within the first 2, 3 seconds, whether it's aesthetically pleasing or you're already discounting it. But then you have an emotional response to that, and that's absolutely huge. So when I think about what you do, that's phenomenal. That's a huge undertaking that you're actually bringing on.
Thank you. Yeah, I love it, and that's something that it's really hard with new clients because you don't know kind of where they're trying to go in the direction of their business, and especially when it's virtual meetings, you know, you're not getting to know someone face to face. I feel like you really have to hone in on like what their personality is. If it's like a silly kids clothing brand or if it's a church, like that's going to be a totally different. Like, you want a different emotion that's invoked when you're looking at that brand.
That's huge, and that's hard. That's the hard part. If it
Yeah.
were easy, everybody, I could be a graphic designer, and I could just use the same cookie cutter, formula for everybody. But that's not how it works. Like, even at different people's houses, I know that's a little bit different from a design spot, but
No,
it's
totally.
where you
I completely.
live.
I agree with that completely. One of my best friends is an interior designer, and I'm like, can you just come design my house? And she, because it looks so like everyone else's, and that's not, you know, that's not what you want to put off. And I feel like it's the same way with your company.
Oh, very cool. What would be your dream project to work on as a graphic designer?
Well, I love everything that's beachy and tropical. So probably something that has to do with that. Actually, I used to say that my dream job would be designing wine and beer labels. Just
Nice.
I feel like they're so fun. Every, you know, bottle has a different brand. It's a completely new identity every single time. It's just fun. Like, that's why, I mean, especially like if you go into a store and you're trying a new beer or a new wine, like you're picking it based off the label. Like 100%. Everyone does, and I feel like that's like something everyone can identify with. And I was like, that would just be such a fun job to, you know, be able to connect with somebody and be like, this is your bottle of wine right here because you connect with this label.
Oh, that's huge. Yeah, I'm like, I think especially birthday is like, okay, this is my birthday bottle of wine. Because,
Yes.
I mean, I have buddies, they have their own beer and that's their birthday beer, but we all have the same label. Now, if you had a label that had your name and your design on it,
Yeah.
yeah, that would make birthdays much more epic. No, that's pretty cool. Well, when you do that, let us know because I would love to be your first customer on that. That's pretty cool. Have
I'll
your
keep you
own
posted.
label. For wines and beers, huh?
Yeah. I just feel like, you know, that's
That's cool.
something that everyone loves, makes people happy. It's a good business.
Can't lose. Can't lose. So you're doing a lot. Who do you go to bounce these ideas off of right now? Is there anybody that you look to who inspires you, whether it be in your actual community or on social media that you're really following that's helping you along right now?
Yeah, I feel like I'm bringing up Rising Tide so much, but that's just because they've been so awesome, you know, to have a group of creatives that they might not be in a graphic designer, but they're going through the same things. You know, they're trying to grow their business, and some days it's really great. Some days you're signing your dream client, and some days it's really hard where, you know, you're like, is this even worth it that I'm putting in all these hours? And just to have people that know what you're going through and have been there, can offer advice, I feel like it's huge. And then I have a group of graphic designers just like from college or just knowing from past jobs that if I'm like, hey, I'm so stuck, like, what do you, when you hear like these words, like, what are you like seeing in your head? Just because I feel like you always bring your own ideas to a project, but to have someone else step in and be like, actually, like, I think this could be within what they want is huge. I mean, you definitely need like a team of people to like bounce stuff off of, to like pick you up on those bad days. That's just so important. And I feel like having people in your hometown is huge too, because it's different to just look on social media and say, like, wow, like, this person is like awesome, like, I want to be just like them, but also, like, they're at a way different point in their career than I am. But to have people like local, you can be like, hey, I'm just having a rough day. Like, let's go get dinner. Like, let's go on a run and just like talk. And I just want to know like what you would do in this situation. I feel like it just makes it so much more real, and it's building a community, not like a competition over
Oh, I
a
like
business.
that. I like that. That's cool. So, Rising Tide, is that like a secret group, or can you talk more about how, yeah, I'm like, I don't know if I should say this. How did you find them? Did they find you, or did you
Yeah,
meet?
it's definitely not secret. I found them off of social media.
Yeah.
They have a big Instagram presence, and I had just been following them for a while, and then I heard them say on one of their posts that they have like local chapters, and I was just thinking it was this website you could go to for, you know, financial advice for your small business, legal advice for your small business, that kind of stuff. And when they said they had local chapters, I was like, man, like, I really got to become a part of this. And I found one that Wilmington had, and I think like most big cities have one, and it's just been awesome. I feel like every time I go, I just learn so much. Like, I learned so much stuff that I didn't even know that I didn't know, you know? It's just like, I didn't even know I had to think about this whole aspect, or like, there's this new app that'll do this part of my business for me, and I don't have to think about it anymore. It's just been awesome. I feel like every time I go, I learn so much.
So it's a lot of people from different backgrounds. It's not only.
Yeah, it's anyone who is an entrepreneur. You can be, there's like people who have made jewelry, photographers, designers, artists, planners, other like lawyers who are starting their own businesses. It's just kind of all over the board, all ages. And I feel like that just makes it so much cooler too. You know, everyone's bringing their different backgrounds into the group and just bounces ideas off of each other. Every month there's like a different theme. Like this last month it was networking. There was one on like finances. So every month there's like a different topic, and you kind of like do your own research, figure out what's working for your business, and you just bring, it's like an open forum where you can talk to other people, figure out what's working for them, what's not working for them. Just kind of building each other up, figuring out the best way to run your business. Yeah, it's really cool.
Cool. So working with Rising Tide and your business is doing great things, like what's the point where you feel like, okay, and I know we're ambitious, you're definitely the type of person who's gonna keep striving for more, but where's like a milestone where you feel like, okay, as a graphic designer, I feel like Kyle Myers Designs has done something pretty awesome right now. Like what's one of your biggest goals right now?
That's so tricky. I would love to be able to just have a good enough base of clients where I can really focus on those that are they're gonna be my core clients, that I just love what they're doing. I can get behind their brand, instead of just, you know, picking up all kinds of clients. I feel like that's when I'll know that I've like really found my like tribe of people that I connect with, that I can bring. able to do what I'm good at and not necessarily like turn away people that don't necessarily connect with my brand, but be able to point them in the direction of someone who might be able to help their business succeed in a better way. I feel like that's huge. Like, I know so many graphic designers here in Wilmington, and we kind of have already started to point people in the right direction to get to the vibe that they're looking for, the style that they're looking for. And just to be able to work with people that I really connect with their mission. I love working with nonprofits, especially just to like help them do what they're doing. I feel like that's, every time I get to sign a new like nonprofit, I feel like that's a little success. Like today I worked with a pregnancy care, crisis pregnancy care in Greensboro.
Yeah.
And just did like a little quick graphic for them. I was like, you know, that was just a small thing, but I felt like it was just so awesome to be able to do. It's that kind of stuff that you're going to remember way down the road.
So you work with nonprofits. It seems like you're really into the social good aspect of business as well. How does that tie into what you want to do with your company?
Yeah, I feel like it all just goes back to, I want to be here to like build up other entrepreneurs. You know, I feel like when people come up with their business plan, everyone's so pumped. Everyone just like wants to get off and rolling.
Yeah.
And they're like, well, where do I start? And I feel like one of the exciting parts of starting a business is like getting your logo and your website. Like, it's not the boring stuff of like getting legally a business, like all that kind of stuff. It's the fun part. So I love when people come to me and like, this is my idea again. I'm so excited about it. And like, I just want to see my website up. I want to see my brand out. I want to get business cards. I'm ready to go. And that's just what I love to do. I love to connect with people. I love to hear their stories. And just to see like their businesses become a success, I feel like that makes my business feel like a success. You know, I want to
100%.
See the businesses that I brand go on to do like really awesome things. Because then when you see them making like great strides, you're like, I remember when you were just starting out, like didn't even know if you were gonna make it, like you're gonna be able to pay your rent. Like now you're killing it. Like this is awesome. I feel like that is just gonna be an awesome feeling to see these companies that I brand go on to make like millions and have employees and change the world. That's going to just be so cool.
I've never heard it from that perspective before. It's really cool because Mentorch, and now you're going to hear it kind of from my perspective as well, from the customer of the design and the brand. But I was working with a graphic design company in Baltimore, Maryland, called Fat Cat Studios. And I think they did a great job, probably because I told them this is what I wanted, and they did a great, they brought it to life, which is really, really interesting. And I actually would love to get your take on that, because for a lot of the things you're doing, right, someone's saying, this is what I'm thinking, this is what I'm thinking, and now you're like, okay, what you said doesn't make any sense, or hey, okay, I can see what your vision is, and then you're putting it on paper. You're really making something that doesn't exist at all and bringing it to life. And that's really cool, just hearing your perspective of you help them bring it to life and then they go on to do things. And like, yeah, you are 100% part of that. And you get the opportunity to do that with a lot of different companies. Whereas I do it with my company and that's it, right? So I'm with my company, but you're like, yeah, I designed that one, that one, that one, that one, that one, that one. And I went through DC with my Uncle William. He's an architect, and he did the same thing with buildings that I've driven past a lot of times. And I'm like, oh, that's a really cool building. And then one day he was like, yeah, I helped design that. I helped build that bridge. I'm like, this is crazy.
Yeah, that's wild. And I feel like it's just, I don't know, it's like your little like babies going out into the world, you know? Like, you want to see them do like great things.
Yeah. It's like, go ahead, my children. Go forth and conquer. No, that's really cool to hear that.
Yeah.
So, ambitious, hardworking, talented. Who would you give credit to as mentors as you've grown up and to this point that contributed to where you are today?
Oh my gosh, so many. Definitely, like, first, my mom. I was raised by a single mom, and she was just, like, definition of, like, boss. Like,
yeah.
Just, like, killed it. She loves to work,
Yeah.
is killing it in the workplace, still killing it. Just got a promotion,
Nice.
just like props. And I feel like that's just, instilled so much in me to just want to work hard to see what you can do, just always keep pushing yourself to
Yeah.
be better. Even when you have your dream job, how can you make it better? How can you make people around you better? I feel like she definitely taught me that so much. And my first boss when I lived in DC, she, I was fresh out of college, scared to death, living in DC, didn't know what I was doing. And she was just like, fake it till you make it, get out there, hustle, go talk to this person, act like you know what you're talking about. And I was like, but I don't know what I'm talking about. She's like, nobody knows what they're talking about. Just go do it.
That's huge, yeah.
And I mean, those are the first two that come to my mind, so many in between. But yeah, I feel like just I learned so much, like my first job in DC, just being able to put myself in crazy situations and where I didn't know what I was doing, but I was just like, I'm gonna try this, and if it works, awesome. If it doesn't, learning experience.
Yeah.
I feel like that was just a really cool opportunity. And DC, is just so much different than Wilmington. I felt like I was always trying to hustle and step up the ladder, and then I tried to tone it down when I came to Wilmington, because here that's a little scary for a beach town. But I try to find a happy medium where I'm still trying to push myself, get out there, networking, which is the scariest word ever, trying to get out there and just meet people, push myself, grow my business. And I feel like both those women just are always still, talking in my ear and hey, how's it going? Are you making strides? Are you writing your goals down every day and sticking them to your meat here? You need to see those every single day.
Yeah. I mean, and not even having to talk to them every day or every time, because they seem to have made a huge impact on you, and so that's gonna carry you through however long, until maybe the next time you have a conversation.
Yeah. No, definitely. I mean, I can't get over it enough. I feel like you have to have people in your life that will constantly push you,
No.
because you're not gonna push yourself. I mean, I think there's a very few amount of people that will be able to be like, I need to get to this point, I need to get to this point. But to have someone in your life who's been there, who knows what to do, knows your personality, and they're like, this is your next step, this is what you need to do, this is how you're gonna get better. Keep throwing yourself outside your comfort zone. I feel like that's just so important, because speaking for myself, I know I would not do that. I would watch Netflix and not ever push myself to be outside of my comfort zone and try to grow my business. And
Yeah.
I just have to constantly remind myself and schedule stuff to make myself go outside of my comfort zone, try to grow as a person instead of, being a recluse.
What do you schedule? What do you schedule to grow out of your comfort zone? Is it like meetups or are you network events?
Yeah, well, since I work from home,
Yeah.
try to schedule something every single day
Nice.
where I have to leave the house. Because it's so easy to just work from home, live at home, never really go anywhere, whether that's last week I went to two networking events, which was so scary. But I was like, I've got to do it. And whether it's just drinks with somebody that you've wanted to get to know in your hometown.
Right.
There was a couple girls that are big bloggers here in Wilmington. And I was like, I love what they're doing. I'm just gonna ask them to go get drinks. So I'm getting drinks with them next week. And it might be weird, it might be awkward, but it might also be awesome. You just never know. And I feel like those are the awkward risks you have to take
Yes.
to figure out if this is gonna be something that brings joy to your life, or something that is just another thing on your to-do list that you're kind of dreading. And if it's something that brings joy, then that's something you should keep pursuing.
Definitely. Like you grow from the weird, the awkward, the challenging, and then
Yeah.
you're like, oh, that wasn't so bad when you look back. I'm glad I did it.
Yeah, and whether that's a kickball game with some random people that you know from a bunch of group of friends. Like, I did that, and I'm horrible at kickball. I have, like, terrible flashbacks to sixth grade where, like, I missed the ball. And, but those are the things that you're going to remember 3 weeks later and be talking about on a podcast. Not sitting at home watching Stranger Things.
Oh, yeah. If you get into that, some people... They're going to give you some comments about that. Like, hey, don't go after Stranger Things now. But you're right. Like, and that goes into the... I love how you use your time. Because I'm not going to sit here and lie. Like, I do watch Netflix from time to time. But it's so much less than it used to be. And, like, you're using your time really, really productively by going out there and actually... meeting people, because with MentorTorch and with anything, especially technology, it's so easy not to go out and meet people and just use technology. But, you know, I believe that it's there so that it's easier to actually meet these people, not so that you don't have to go out and meet people.
Right. The biggest thing that's helped me recently is I have this, like, hugely annoying planner where I'll, like, write down everything from my day, like, schedule everything, my work hours, and then whether it's dinner with a friend, I try to, like, schedule that in, schedule my going to the gym, you know, all this different stuff that I need to do, answering emails, meeting up with new clients, because otherwise you get off work and suddenly it's 8 o'clock at night and you have done nothing.
Yeah.
You know, I feel like if you write it down, then you're more likely to, like, check it off. You're more likely to make sure that you actually show up to stuff instead of just bailing out. I mean, that's how I am, at least. I love to have a list and check things off, and that's my type A personality.
Yeah. I mean, I'm the same way, and it holds you accountable. You can look at the list, and you're like, oh, okay, that's still on there. And then it's okay to reprioritize, and I do that too. Sometimes what was number one on Monday is not number one again by Tuesday or Wednesday, and I'll just reprioritize and then keep going down. So it's a great way to do that. But you're right, you have to write it down, and you have to keep referencing back to it.
Yeah, it's just so easy to waste time. And I always say, like, Beyonce has the same number of hours in the day.
Yeah, like, she has like 26 hours or something like that, I think.
Yeah, you just have to figure out how to best use your hours.
Yeah. All right, so curious, right? So if someone is a graphic designer and they're like, oh my gosh, Kyle Myers' design is so awesome, like, I draw stick figures, I want her to be my mentor, how did they make that happen, and what are the expectations you would have for that relationship? Like, kind of walk us through how you would want a mentoring relationship to go.
Oh gosh. I mean, just like reaching out on social media, I feel like is a great place to start. I'm always on there, like, more than I would like to admit. And I just truly want to see people get better. You know, if you're saying, I've realized that people can have a great idea for their business. They can say they have all the passion in the world, but you can't force them to, like, take the next step in their business. And they can just talk, but if they're not willing to put in, you know, the legwork and the time and the hard hours and the missing hanging out with friends on the weekend to, like, put in the sweat equity of their business, then you can't force people to do that. So I would definitely, you know, want to work with people that are willing to put in that time, to know that it's not going to be easy all the time, and sometimes it might be super easy and it might be super fun, but other times it's not going to be super easy and super fun. And just to see growth. I mean, that whether that's slow growth, whether that's fast growth, like, that's amazing, but it's probably going to be slow growth. Because I feel like that's what real success is. There's no such thing as overnight success. You have to put in the work to be where you want to be. And just to find someone that wants to do that and not just say that you can't just talk about it, you have to be about it.
Yeah, I like it. And that's straight up. That's real talk. This is where you stand, and your expectations, as long as you are upfront about how you want the relationship and you talk about it early, then everything else should be smooth sailing for the most part.
Yeah, like I'm not gonna sugarcoat it. Like I wanna, you know, life is not gonna be a breeze and you have to be willing to do the hard work. And I love people that are willing to do the hard work. I mean, there's the people I look up to, people that haven't had it easy, who just kept pushing to get to where they want to be.
Definitely. So, would it only be women entrepreneurs? Would it only be women graphic designers? Or I'm just curious, like, and I think it's awesome that you're really focused on empowering the women around you. But what if there is a guy entrepreneur? He's like, oh man, like I really like her work. Would she work with me? But she says she only wants to work with other women. 'Cause I know there's
Yeah,
someone out there, and they're wondering this.
definitely,
Yeah.
definitely. I would say that work with anyone. I'm not gonna discriminate one way or the other. Definitely, my mission is to empower women, and that is something that, you know, I'm really passionate about. But I mean, I want everyone to, you know, do well, and I want
Pushing.
their business to thrive.
I gotta just say,
Humans
guys.
to thrive.
Yeah.
What can you do well?
That guy's like, yes, okay, I can reach out to her. I don't have to go find someone else now. Cool. So tell us about, and we've kind of already gone into it a little bit, but we'll dive a little bit more in depth about a resource that you use that's really contributing to your success today.
Oh gosh, you know what I'm gonna bring up. I love like the hometown. I love getting to know people in my hometown. So any kind of networking that's in Wilmington or North Carolina, like I love that. Whether that's alumni groups from colleges in North Carolina or friends being like, hey, I need you to meet this person. They have a small business. I feel like that those are the clients that you're gonna remember, and like that's gonna be what makes your like business a success, not just the easy of like going to a website where somebody needs to hire a graphic designer and they don't actually know what you're about. I mean, they aren't going to care about you at the end of the day. And that's like what I want out of my business. I want to work with people that I care about, that care about me. And I feel like the best resource of meeting that dream client is getting out in my community, getting to know people at volunteer stuff. You know, kickball events, volleyball games, getting to know the people in my community and building that up. And I feel like social media is great for that too, you
It's
know.
huge. Huge.
And, you know, people can figure out where you are based on your social media. They can connect with you. And it's easy. You have no excuse. Like, if you meet someone out, you can so easily find them on social media.
Yeah.
Everyone's on social media. And then you can further that relationship, have a client out of that, and grow your business.
I mean, how did we discover each other? Like it was through social media, completely through social media. We didn't meet at an event. We didn't, and now people are like, "Do you want me to leave my house or do you not?" Because we didn't even have to leave the house. And it's like,
That's
oh,
true.
this is amazing. My wife was telling me about it. She was like, "I really love the work she's doing. I think we should have her on the show. Like you should check everything out." And I was like, "Oh yeah, definitely. Like all for it." But that's how we found you.
Yeah, but the
So.
beauty of social media is now that I know you guys are right near me and I'm gonna be there tomorrow,
Yeah,
and
she's like,
like,
I'm gonna move now.
yeah,
They're too
now
close.
we can be friends in real life.
Yeah, no, we'll and so absolutely, you're not crazy far, so we'll definitely have to link up and continue the friendship.
Yes.
No, that's pretty awesome. Like right down in old Wilmington, we're in Jacksonville. That's nothing.
Yeah. Man, that's great. And I feel like that I've always was so sketched out by people that were like, oh, I met friends on social media, but like it really does happen. It sounds crazy, but it really happens. And if you can continue that in real life, I feel like that is awesome.
That's
Because
it.
everyone's life is on social media, so I feel like you get a good idea of who they are as a person, you know?
It's like there's a theme here, like,
Yeah.
okay, graphic design, beautiful. You know, designs make you feel good, but eventually, everyone, it's all about leaving the social media or leaving your big wallet of social media, Instagram, Facebook, Snapchat, your personal website, and going into the real world, you
Yeah,
know,
I mean,
because
they can work together. They can help improve each other, you know?
100%. That and that's the most beautiful design of it all, is actually meeting, you know. Okay, now I'm gonna go into the deeper, darker. I always call it the deeper, darker side of the interview because I ask for the biggest obstacle that you've ever faced. It doesn't necessarily have to be a failure, but it has to be something that challenged you. And then we can talk about whether a mentor was there to help, or if there wasn't a mentor there, like why would a mentor have made it easier?
I would say just my very first, what I like to call awful client was just
Those exist?
I wouldn't say like the hardest thing I've ever been through in my entire life,
Yeah.
but within my business,
Yeah.
just because I think that design is just like a very like personal thing. You know, you're creating something that like you said, didn't exist previously, and it's something that you're passionate about, and to send it to a client and they're just like, I hate this. This is awful. Like, why am I paying you? To hear that for the first time was just like, you know, I felt like it was attacking like my character, like my ability, because it was something that like I had created. And that was like a really hard lesson to learn, but I was really thankful that I learned it early on. Because it truly, I was like, I can't do this anymore. Like, I can't have people just
Oh,
tell me that
wow.
it's that, because, you know, the quote came out to be, my fourth grade niece could have done a better job. Which was
Wow,
like
that's horrible.
really
That's
hard thing to hear.
so mean.
I know. So, and so unnecessary.
Yeah, like really?
I think I called one of my coworkers, and it was, well, actually, no, I called one of my coworkers, and it was like 11 o'clock at night, and they were still working. And they were like, you know what? Like, this was the worst thing that I've ever heard. And they like said whatever a client had said to them that was the worst thing that they ever heard. And they were like, and so and so has this thing that a client has said that was the worst thing they've ever heard. And just to know that people are gonna be mean and it's gonna be hard, especially when your only communication with someone is email or the phone and they don't have to see your face.
That's right.
I feel like I mean, that's the world we live in, and people are gonna be not always nice. But to just learn that like really early on, I feel like was a hard lesson, but it was really awesome to learn and to have someone say like, you're not the only person that's been told that a fourth grader can do a better job. Like we all have had that comparison.
No.
Was really awesome. And still, even now, when I send out like my first round of designs to a client, I like get a little butterflies in my stomach. I'm like, oh my gosh, like are they gonna hate it? Like are they gonna tell me that their third grader could have done a better job, and that's even worse. Like,
My dog could have done it better. What?
yeah.
What is going on?
So, I don't know. It's just to have that so early on, I feel like I prepared myself more, and to hear those criticisms, and some people just aren't gonna like it, some people aren't gonna know how to express that except to lash out.
Yeah.
And having other people say that, you know, I've had this too, made it a lot easier because I was like, thought I was the failure, I was the problem, but you know, everyone has those days.
Yeah. Feel like, well, you told me to do this. Like, this is what you told me to make.
Be great.
Your idea is worse than a fourth grader's idea. That's cool. Hey, yes. There are definitely horrible people out there, and it's unfortunate that a lot of us have had to have that interaction with them, but it is cool. Yeah, that's the right word. It is cool when you're looking around and you're like, well, this person said this, and you're like, well, that's messed up. And you realize, yeah, you're not alone, and you're just
Yeah.
gonna keep get you're gonna keep getting better. They're gonna be horrible people still, and and the world's gonna keep rotating, so
Yeah, and
might as
just to
well.
know that, like, to have that community and like be able to laugh about it, because at the time, like, I'm pretty sure I was crying about it. I wasn't laughing about it. But to have people that then, like, you know, that's like a story that I tell people like pretty regularly now. Like when they have a client say that they hate something, I'm like, well, it can't be worse than this. Like, this is what I had.
Yeah.
And, you know, people can like laugh it off. And it's, you know, it went from being like the most horrible thing that could have been said to like now I tell people all the time and it's hilarious and it's used to make them feel better.
Yeah.
Oh my and gosh. I don't know. It's like, just become a great thing, great story to tell.
So, like, your next time you go out with the ladies and you guys are going out for drinks, everybody has to bring the worst thing.
Yeah.
And then whoever whoever has the worst thing at every round has to drink or buy the next round of drinks.
Oh my gosh, that would be hilarious.
Or they get their drink for free. Whoever has actually has, they're like, oh my gosh, that was really bad. Okay, you get
that's
your
a good
drink.
One.
Yeah, because you have to have a sense of humor. And be able to tough skin and
yeah,
let it roll off.
Yeah. You know, it makes you stronger and people are gonna either like it or not gonna like it. And that doesn't change your abilities.
No. That's awesome. I'm glad. Resilient and tough and you're gonna continue to do great things. And just keeping you motivated, especially someone talks about fourth grade skills, which I'm just like dumbfounded. What's like a poem or a short passage or a mantra that you love to read or think about that motivates you throughout your days?
Well, one of them I already said, the 60-hour, the entrepreneur is the only person that'll work 60 hours a week, so they don't have to work 40.
No.
I love that one. And then something that I use, or I like say all the time when I'm designing, I think Chuck Close is the one who said this. He's an artist.
Mm.
But he said, inspiration is for amateurs. The rest of us just get up and go to work.
Mm.
And I love that because I feel like when I was first starting as a designer, you know, I would always like be searching for this amazing like inspiration. I was like, I have to go to a beautiful park or go meditate or read the Bible to like just have this inspiration hit.
Yes.
And then when I got an actual job where I was like, I had to do something for the client by Friday, whether I had inspiration or not,
mm-hmm.
I realized that I was making what I was gonna, like, I was coming up with stuff that I was just as proud of, whether if I had taken 2 weeks to design it or 2 days.
Oh, wow.
And I just love that quote because it's so true, you know? I feel like when you're doing something for fun and you're an amateur at it, that you can take time to find like the inspiration behind it. But if you have to get a product to a client, you have to get a product to a client. You're gonna end up working through that quote unquote writer's block to get something that you're happy with to them. And I just love that. I always try to think of that when I'm feeling unmotivated or not necessarily inspired for a certain client. But inspiration is for amateurs. Everyone else just goes to work.
No, that's really cool. I've never heard that quote before, but I can definitely see the application and just go and do it. You have the passion and the motivation for it, so it's going to come out. And you're going to look at the paper or whatever you're working on and see a good product.
Yeah, you can't get it in your head. You just have to put pen to paper and go for it.
Very cool. Wow. We've got to the pass the torch portion of the podcast already. That's wild. That's wild. But I'm excited about it. I'm excited about it. Torch holders, we have arrived at that time in our program where our guest, Kyle Myers, has 1 minute to pass the torch and leave a legacy. We all know a mentor is a person who has achieved a level of success that we desire and could effectively guide us to success as well. Based on the success you, Kyle, have achieved at this point in your life, if you could pass the torch and leave a legacy message to your former self and anyone in a similar situation, how would you pass the torch in 1 hot minute?
Okay, I would say that real success is slow success. You're not gonna just wake up one day and be at the place in your business that you want to be at. There's gonna be moments of doubt and fear, and there's also new moments. moments of extreme clarity and awesomeness. And you need to take both of those with a grain of salt, because tomorrow when you wake up, it might be the opposite. And you just have to keep pushing forward no matter what, to remember your goal and where you're trying to be, and just not, don't believe your feelings, you know? Like, some days you're going to feel like a failure, some days you're going to feel like a loss. Like, just don't believe your feelings. Like, just keep pushing forward to what you actually want. And, yeah, that's it.
Love it. Love it, love it. There you go. Kyle Myers passing the torch. Graphic designer, Kyle Myers Designs. This has been another episode of Pass the Torch Podcast. You are with Levante Santos and Kyle Myers, and we are reminding you to seek knowledge and pass the torch. Boom.
Boom.
Great job.
That was awesome.
Great job. That went to pretty much an hour.
Wrapped that was so up. Fun.
I took way more of your time than I was supposed to because of the Skype messing up, so I really apologize about that. I do not like wasting anyone's time.
No, you're fine. Don't even sweat it.
Being very, very flexible and patient.
Yeah, this was awesome.
Yeah, I had fun. This was really cool.
When will it go out?
So we post every Wednesday. We have like three recordings before you. So yeah, it'll be like, I think a few weeks. But what I think I'm gonna do is switch it up on people, and I post, and I'm like experimenting with this, like previews and stuff like that. So they're gonna be like, who's this? And then a few weeks later, they're gonna see you again. So I'm gonna probably post it soon, and then right before we do yours. So the promo will go up, and then right before we post yours again, it'll go up again. So I think I'm gonna do that going into next week, because I this one, the other ones are really good too, but yours is like, the energy was there, and I like the subject of what we talked about. So
awesome.
Very, very cool. You did a great job. Natural interviewee, and you have a networking personality. So I don't know how you would ever have a hard time doing that. I don't see it, but.
Oh, thank you.
Yeah. Oh, cool, cool.
Yeah, this was so fun. And next time I'm up there, I'm going to shoot you a little Instagram message.
Yeah.
Because I want to meet you and your wife in real life.
Let's do it. When did you say you were coming?
I'll be up there this weekend, but it's my mother-in-law's like birthday/retiring party, so probably be on that fam life the whole time. But my husband's actually living up in Jacksonville right now.
Yeah.
He's in PA school, and he's doing his surgery rotation up there.
Whew. Oh my gosh.
So I'm up there all the time, because he's up there for the next 4 weeks.
Well, I know Eileen would love to make that happen.
Yeah, is the best way to contact you on the Mentorch, like, messages?
You can find us on Facebook.
Okay.
That'll be definitely better. Because, we do use Mentorch, but, like, that's, like, the initial business side, but you're now family, so just find us on Facebook. And that'll be way, way easier.
Sounds good. This was so fun.
Definitely. Kyle, it's a pleasure.
Thank you for reaching out.
Yeah. If I can help you with anything, just don't hesitate to reach out.
Thanks. Yeah.
My network is your network, so.
Thank you.
I'm excited to see what you come up with and the great things you're going to do.
Thanks. You have a good night.
You too.
Bye.
Bye-bye.